We are the Syndicate.
Hello and welcome.
You may be wondering how you got here.
You may be wondering your choice of podcast.
In this series, you'll hear a variety of stories that may or may not be fact or fiction.
Welcome to the Syndicate.
If you can't believe the unbelievability, then there's something wrong with the writing.
It may be said with a degree of assurance that not everything that meets the eye is as it appears.
There is nothing in the dark that isn't there when the lights are on.
But it makes you wonder, doesn't it? Just how normal we are? And just who are the people we say our hellos to?
A rather good question to ask.
Especially on the
Syndicate.
Hello everyone, welcome back to the Syndicate Files here on the Syndicate channel. Today we're going to talk about Icarus First Cohort. And as always, I'm Deuce MS, along with AO Mike 83.
Hey, everyone.
Bone 13.
Hello.
Gaming Gargle.
Hey.
And getting into Icarus First Cohort today. My words are not coming out good, so you're going to have to bear with me a little bit here. Icarus is a session-based PvE survival game for up to 8 co-op players or solo. Explore a savage alien wilderness in the aftermath of a terraforming gone wrong. Survive long enough to make to mine exotic matter, then return to orbit and craft more advanced tech. Meet your deadline or be left behind forever. And as always, we'll leave links to Steam down below, as well as links to the YouTube channel with the videos that we're going to check out today as well. We'll be reading over some of these. So RocketWorks, Rocket Two Guns is the guy that started RocketWorks. And he's also, if the name sounds familiar, if the dev team sounds familiar, I think he and Brian Hicks started DayZ Mod back on Arma 2 and then developed DayZ Standalone and then sold it, of course, to Bohemia. So he's got some good games under his belt that were, you know, that are really still really big games. A lot of people still play DayZ. So he's also got a few other games under his belt, too. So if you want to go check out RocketWorks on Steam, you can do that as well. We'll leave a link to the Icarus page down below. You can find their dev, all their developer stuff from there. I think maybe just watching the videos is probably good, but I do always like to go over the minimum requirements or whatever system requirements they have listed. So we'll get that out of the way. Windows 10 64-bit, Intel i5 8400, 16 gigs of RAM, NVIDIA GTX 1060, DirectX 11. With network broadband internet connection and 70 gigs of storage. That's big.
That's a big Minor. Game.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's yeah. A lot.
I can fit it in my pocket.
Yeah. technically, yeah, you can buy
I know.
You can probably get a 1 terabyte thumb drive nowadays, can't
yeah,
you?
Yeah, probably so.
See, I can fit it in my pocket. I'm good.
Yeah. I mean there's a few other things here. There's a bout and then you know there's a few other things. But I mean, that's a very base idea what it is. I feel like if we just pop over and start watching these videos here, we'd probably be better off than me continue reading because it's a session-based PvE survival game for up to 8 co-op players. I mean, that says enough right there. You need to see it to believe it. And if you haven't seen the game yet, then man, are you in for a shock because this game looks phenomenal. It's got a story too, right, guys?
Yes.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Great story. All right, let's flip over here, and we're going to check out Icarus No Rescue. This is a, what would you call this? Somebody help me out here.
A film featured trailer,
yeah. So this builds the story with it. So let's flip over here and check this out. Here we go. It's called Icarus No Rescue. And again, we'll leave links down below to the Icarus channel and these individual videos.
Icarus was supposed to be a second Earth, some kind of paradise, brought to you by the best scientific minds in the universe. Yeah, right.
You know, when did they call it Icarus? Big planet-sized dream that came crashing down.
They had no idea what they were in for. No one did.
F*** it up. Pure and simple.
I've done a lot of crazy in my time, eh? But Icarus, that was next level. If you couldn't find food, you died. If you couldn't find oxygen, you died. If you couldn't find shelter from the storms, you died.
Oh, you died a lot.
Died a lot, yeah.
You died a lot.
It sounds like.
Yeah.
And
I'm just loving at how many different biomes they've already showed us, and we haven't even gotten to a full minute of the
trailer. I mean, look how you can tell the graphics of the game, because even when they switch from real to cinematic, game cinematic, it is hard to pick up the details on what is what.
That is true. That is true. And feel free to pop in at any point. Say stop or whatever. But I know we're not trying to go for like 4 hours of this, and this is a pretty long trailer. So
yeah.
What? We're not long-winded. No, not at all.
Not at all. No.
No. She's an engineer. Xeno engineer. She was sent with a team to terraform the place. So yeah, she was there when it all went to hell.
The other guys, they left as soon as they could. But not Mo. That wasn't her style.
She was there to make money. Like the rest of us.
People died on Icarus all the time, you know? You just tried not
What's to... What's Santa Claus about. Doing in the game?
I'm going to bring my red no shirt for this game.
Well, the journey to Icarus was brutal. It was 4 light years from Earth. 30 trillion miles. And 2 years in long sleep. I mean... Talk about jet lag.
I don't think jet lag would be my main concern at the moment.
No,
probably not. We're worried about gravity effect or lack of gravity effects on my body. Yeah,
didn't know that Santa Claus was in the game.
He is. Yeah.
He is definitely in the game. Yeah,
that character reminds me of like old Prospector characters.
Yeah, yeah, for sure. One. Well, I mean, that's what they're doing, though.
Yeah. It's what I mean. They chose a good actor for this. Yeah. He just reminds you of what you think an old prospector would look like.
Yeah, that's exactly what they're doing, though. They're prospecting. So, makes sense. Right? Kinda?
Mm-hmm.
Down with that.
Absolutely.
We were the first cohort. We were the first wave of cowboys. You know, it was a whole new planet. It was unreal. And reality kicked in.
Oh, they opened up Icarus to prospectors when all the terraforming went. So I signed on as soon as I could.
She offered to drop with us. She wanted to show us around like was it her apartment or something.
Well, I figure she just wanted to see how we do on the first drop.
It was like going back in time and seeing the Earth a million years ago.
The trees, the plants, the animals, they're from Earth. I mean, the bio team had adapted them after the terraforming went. But Jesus Christ, it does your head in at first.
Bear sounds good.
Outside the zone.
Bear looks good.
It was different.
Yeah, people always think we had a bunch of advanced tech up there, but we had nothing. We spent everything just trying to get there. We're like cave people in spacesuits those first few drops. If we needed shelter or tools or something, well, we had to make it ourselves.
I barely made it back to the dropship alive that first time. Yeah, I got better, of course. I mean, Mo taught me some. She taught me how to build shelters, find oxygen. But the best thing she taught me was, you got to respect that planet, not to fear it.
She was smart. I mean, cocky as hell, but look, she'd been part of the terraforming group, right? So she knew the planet inside and out. I mean, literally, right?
She spoke about it all the time, you know, about the first time terraforming and wasn't going to work. And about finding the first exotics.
That's gameplay right there, by the way.
Mm-hmm.
It may be a cinematic.
Amazing.
But
yeah, I was going to say, it looks like it's been touched a little bit with a little bit of the brush. But other than that, though, it looks really good.
Yeah. I mean, that's fantastic looking. Yeah, I mean,
the drill penetrating down into the ground and all that. You can actually see its rotational force. It looks good.
Yeah, it looks awesome.
I'm just saying. Doesn't it feel like a coincidence that they declared the planet uninhabitable just when they discovered the most valuable material in the universe? Weird, eh? Hey, I ain't complaining. I did okay out of it.
It was the exotics that killed the terraforming. Screwed with the enzymes. Then again, they changed everything. I mean, without the exotics, there never would have been a first cohort. Because it was all about the exotics. You find them. You sell them back at the station, you get more gear, you go back down, find more, drop, survive, and repeat.
On Icarus, a handful of exotics would get you a new suit, a radar, a rifle. But on Earth, it would buy you anything you wanted.
Anything.
That's pretty valuable.
Yeah.
And a brother all the time. Kind of life she could give them thanks to the exotic she'd found.
She didn't stay because she needed the money. She'd made her money. She stayed because she loved it. We all did. It was addictive.
Gameplay.
She was addicted.
That looks amazing.
You felt comfortable on the surface. You take your eye off the mission clock. And that's how people die.
It happened all the time, eh? You're like, people would miss the window to get back to their ship, and then there was no way they'd get back to the station, and that was it. Never see
Don't worry about me, guys. Just taking a nap.
Yeah, die, that's for sure.
A long nap.
The drop started off fine.
None of us had ever been to that part of the planet before, not even Mo.
Prospecting in unfamiliar areas, I hated it. But there was always more exotics and undiscovered areas, so none of us knew what to
or
expect.
Dumbo.
Not back then, but Mo. She was like a moth to a flame.
Gameplay.
Didn't even notice she'd wandered off.
If you're asking me if I feel guilty for what happened to her, I do.
We looked for her as long as we could. But, you know, there's a big storm coming, and you don't hang about for those ever.
A bear attack is my guess. The forests were full of them. I mean, anything could have happened.
Yikes.
It wasn't an accident. Mo didn't come back because she didn't want to come back. She knew she couldn't go home, not after what had happened to that planet in the past.
Look at that.
Mm-hmm.
Well, I'm going to say this now. If I die and you can't find me and you leave, y'all guys are meanies.
Well, I mean,
you left me on a planet.
I would assume you just respawn in the ship, right?
I'll leave you with this, Gargoyle. Sorry about your luck.
Right?
Yeah.
If we go exploring in unexplored areas, and we see the polar bear, you're on your own. Yeah, you're on your own. I'm running. So
y'all already know I'm going to be out there looking for things.
Right. Yeah, we know Mike. Mike's gonna miss the ship because he's gonna be too far away, guaranteed.
Oh yeah.
She knew she couldn't go home. Not after what happened to that planet and the part she had played in it.
What an amazing
show. Mike didn't want to die. She. She was right where she wanted to be.
Can I just say that the acting in this is phenomenal?
Ma. You can, because it is.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
How you guys? You got a girlfriend yet, bro? Sorry, I haven't been in touch. My bad. Just want to say that I'm fine. Today is my last drop. I wish that maybe if the terraforming had worked, you could have been here. Not what people could have been here. I miss you guys. Thank you. You know, I'll see you guys soon.
I'll just say, with the way that she said, I'll see you, to me it shows she knows she's not coming back.
Kind of what it seems like, yeah.
Foreshadowing.
What a trailer, am I right?
Oh, yeah.
Dude.
Man, I love how they did that as a film feature type deal.
Yeah, when a dev company makes something like that for
their marketing
for their game,
mm-hmm.
I mean, it not only shows how much money they put into it, but it also shows how much heart they put into that, right?
Yeah.
I mean, dude, I haven't seen another game do something like that in a while. So
I agree. I think, you know, like it's kind of familiar. Like, I think I've seen trailers like this before, but not in like the last 5-6 years that my memory's pulling up. You know what I mean?
If what my research is correct here, the main female, her name is Jen Lua. And she's married to the main male actor in the cinematic, whose name is Brandon Scott. Brandon Scott has been in a lot of stuff as far as games go. He's been in like Last of Us, Battlefield, Uncharted. The what?
Is that the Aussie sounding guy?
Yes.
The New Zealander, probably. I'm guessing he's from New Zealand.
I cannot find anything that I'm saying I'm right, because I during this whole thing I've been searching everywhere trying to find out who these actors are, and it is tight-lipped right now. So, which is weird, because it's been released, and usually they want that, but I mean, maybe they just went all uncredited type of thing. So, which is possible.
It is very possible, yeah.
So, but yeah.
So Rocket Works is based in New Zealand. So
yeah, it would make sense.
Yeah, Rocket Two Guns is from New Zealand. Company's based out of New Zealand.
Yeah.
So basically, what I'm seeing is y'all are going to make me buy this.
I'm not going to make you do anything.
See, I think
you said that earlier.
This is the dilemma we already have here. You know, we already have too much to play.
Yeah, we're gonna play Fridays in a month.
Yeah, I mean, we're pretty soon. We're gonna have to start Syndicate Mondays,
right? For God's or Syndicate Saturdays.
I know
Sundays, geez, something. We'll be live streaming 5 days a week on the Syndicate channel.
Exactly.
This is how I feel when I pick up too many games to play, right here.
Uh-huh.
It's like, man, I'm going to have to add another day to the week.
Yeah.
I got to say, I do appreciate, though, how much work that they put into this trailer. That was, I like that, and I really do appreciate it. So I'm glad to see that, you know, there's teams that are out there who are, you know.
I mean, it looks like there's a lot more going into this than there was ever in any of those other projects.
For sure. Yeah, for sure.
But he also, he also made a ton of money in his other projects. So maybe now he's using it. So
yeah, so Rocket Works has another game out on Steam, not just DayZ. They didn't just start with DayZ and then sell it to Bohemia. Of course, it belongs to Bohemia now, but Rocket Works also did Station Ears and is currently working on Art of the Rail. They leave some, the other game names. Just the names down there. You can search them up on Steam if you want to. In the description.
Definitely not a one-hit wonder, that's for sure.
Oh, no. No, Rocket Two Guns is pretty well respected in the gaming community as a modder and then as a game dev. So, gotcha. But yeah, he's pretty well respected in the survival, streamer community, yeah.
Which is weird because Art of the Rail has nothing to do with any of that.
No, it doesn't, and that's a whole different topic. But just real quick, the first conversation I saw on that, he said that was his first love of games, is that style of game. So
I mean, it makes sense. He probably grew up with Sid Meier or Chris Chris something. I can't think of his last name. The dude from Planet Coaster, or not Planet Coaster, but Roller Coaster. Yeah, there we go. Yeah,
the Tycoon games.
Yeah, all the tycoon games. Yeah,
yeah, yeah, and I mean that's also very possible.
Sid Meier and him. Yeah,
that's what Art of the Rail is kind of a cartoony style. Like the art style is kind of, it's not realistic art style, but it's kind of a railroad tycoon or something. Yeah,
yeah, it reminds me of Transport Tycoon.
Yeah, there you go. Transport Tycoon. But yeah, either way. So real quick, just to sum up what we just watched. From their orbital station, prospectors drop to the planet's surface for a limited time sessions where they learn to endure the alien environment, complete faction missions, and search for valuable exotic materials. Those that survive return to orbit as seasoned veterans, converting their exotics into advanced technology and taking on ever more challenging drops with newfound knowledge. Those that get left behind are lost forever. So nice. Just another little piece from Steam there. I figured after we watch that, we could get into the, you know, what, why they were dropping and doing that. That's what the game has in store for you. So very cool. You guys want to get to the next video?
Let's go.
Sweetly. Let's do it.
All right. Let's do this.
See some gameplay.
Gameplay. So this came out on June 13th this year, 2021. So Icarus launch date announcement, 4K gameplay trailer, PC Gaming Show 2021. Gameplay trailer. That is a really cool shot there.
Yes. It's so intricate. So intricate with everything that was inside that capsule. And then you see the flames going up over it as you're going into re-entry. Love it.
Yeah. I mean, just look at that.
That is amazing.
It's crazy.
It got right down to the vinyl wrapping around all the books and everything else that were in there. Like, that is awesome. Instead of having, you know, just little cupboards and stuff like that to put everything in. No. They show it to you, but they got that little mesh type stuff holding it to the wall.
Right. Yeah. Look at the
puppy.
Yep. Yeah. I mean, he looks so friendly. Yeah, he looks so friendly, though. Look at the detail and all the stuff going on here. Rocks, the shading, the grass, the water, the trees in the background, the berry bushes. Like,
we could talk for hours just on this picture.
Yeah,
look,
dude,
the lighting
for
alone.
Sure.
Look at how it cascades down. You know what I mean?
The sun rays. Like, yeah, see, dude.
Yeah.
I mean, it looks so good, man. You
imagine,
can see
this with RTX turned on.
Right? Man, I don't even know what RTX is. My computer would explode if I turned that on.
Good ray tracing. Yeah.
Yeah. Look at the pine tree back there. You can see the pine needles, individual needles. That's another one. Look at that.
Yeah. Oh, wow. I mean, this could be a wallpaper on my computer right now.
Dude, I would love it. I think I might actually just screenshot that and not tell anybody about it. Don't tell anybody. Don't tell anybody.
Yeah.
That's my plan.
Even the mountains. Look at the detail in those mountains.
Oh, no, man.
There's hardly a flat space anywhere in comparison to what, you know, you see with a lot of games.
Right.
Shadows on the rock from the sun shining down.
Yeah.
Again, everything. Everything. I can talk for hours.
All right, so we got our first view of people in our spacesuits and a compound bow.
Is that a person or is that what's that R2-D2's friend, CP3 or whatever?
Oh, CP3. My God. What are you, Trekkie or something?
Yeah.
C-3PO, yeah.
I'm not a Star Wars person. I'm sorry.
Yeah, well, yeah, okay.
Hey, I watched the
not everybody's
three,
cool,
which are like the last three or something like that. I don't know how it works anymore.
Anyways, yes, this is a person.
Tree chopping is my favorite.
Yeah.
The wood coming off the tree when you hit it with the axe. Like, wow.
I like the location.
The map is extremely beautiful.
Oh, yeah, it really is. So the building process here looks just phenomenal.
It does.
Like, it looks like
the
a free build,
coming
too.
Coming off of those waters.
Yeah, it does look like it snaps, so that's a good thing.
It's a grid snapping system. I don't like, in games like this, I don't like fully placeable buildings, and then you just put stuff in it.
Pieces into it.
Yeah. So, I mean, having the ability to free build, you get to build something like that around the waterfall, which just looks amazing.
Mm-hmm.
So,
and then everything inside the house there.
Yeah.
You have cooking, you have eating areas, you have a fireplace. Yeah, I mean.
And even the fireplace is made up of different stone packings.
Yep.
You know what I mean?
Yeah. Like, yeah, each little stone
around, and then above the hearth, you got all this. Yeah, you know,
stairs going to the upstairs. You have whatever is in the right in the far left there. I don't know what that is.
I don't like what they did with the roof, though. They could have placed those panels a little bit better.
Yeah, they're all mixed up, man. That's driving me nuts. All the floorboards are going different directions.
The OCD are kicking in now. Yep.
Lori Pops, you got to do a better job at placing floors. I don't know if she was actually, she's there. I think she's the community manager. I don't know if she was actually involved in helping build this or not, but yeah. Details, man.
Mm-hmm.
Phenomenal.
Use the mouse wheel, control Lord.
Oh, wow.
Raindrops.
Wow.
Yeah. I mean, everything there.
I mean, just the lashing and everything that's on.
Flash of lightning right there.
I'm going to try to catch lightning in a bottle here.
All right, good luck.
Just missed it.
Look at that.
There you go.
Yep.
Look at that. I mean, just...
Wow.
Man.
And that's not even the bolt yet.
No. I mean, that's, dude, that's phenomenal. Wow. Oh, there it was.
How it hit the tree.
The demolition there, or the destruction there.
The destruction. Yeah, physics. Yeah, dude. The lightning. Okay, so we know that lightning could definitely take down our house if we're not careful.
We're going to have to go true caveman, build a stone.
Right? Well, that's why we're going to the snow right now. So yeah, we don't want to deal with that.
I'm guessing that's an exotic? A crystal right there?
Could be.
Because they were saying that they were drilling for exotics. So that, to me, like, this is more like a mining. I wonder if it's like just a surface gemstone, maybe.
I mean, it could be, I guess.
Hard to say.
Yeah. That's polar bear.
Hi, bear.
Oh, I tried to hit. Well, it looks like we won. So.
Yes. That right there is awesome.
That is awesome. The lighting of how it cuts through that entire canyon is beautiful.
Yeah, so if this is actual gameplay, look at the difference in detail here as you go into the light, into the cabin.
And how the shutters close and...
Yeah.
There you go. That's a green screen for you.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah, that's... It doesn't seem that bright when you watch it and just let it play, but man. You see it coming up over the top right here.
Mm-hmm.
Again, that's another wallpaper right there.
Yeah, dude, that's a beautiful picture. The biomes in this look phenomenal, dude. I'm just so surprised at how good this game looks. I mean, I shouldn't be, but I am. Oh, there's a grass
out there.
A grass. Yeah. So we've seen wood, we've seen stone, and we've seen grass right here in the middle, yeah.
Yep.
Yeah.
Or it'd be like palm leaves, I guess. Like
palm leaves, yeah. It would have to be the desert.
More and more of a ranch style, or raft style, I mean.
Yeah. That's a big bear. Lost too. All right, so there's a drilling rig.
Yeah, so I think this is the exotics that they're pushing into now, the purple glowy stuff.
And here is the first time you can actually see a face.
Oh, yeah, that's true. Look at that.
Yeah.
Yep, you actually get to see a face. So, do you think we'll have character development stuff?
Customization?
Would assume something of that matter, but I mean, it depends on what. I mean, if it's just a basic survival and you just have rude. I mean, I would assume you're going to have to progress through some type of tree. It's not like you're going to all of a sudden be able to craft the biggest thing in the game, you know?
Oh, that would make sense. Yeah, because if you do your drops, you gain experience, you go back up. Yeah, so that makes sense. Yeah. I think it'd be kind of cool, though, if you couldn't upgrade while you're actually down on Icarus. You would have to go, have to go back up to the ship, right, to do your upgrades. I think that'd be
kind of cool. That would be interesting.
Yeah, so you don't get to use them as you level up. You get to use them once you go back up and then come back.
Right.
Yeah. But I'm sure the drilling rig is not something you're going to start out being able to buy. Like, I feel like you'd be doing it by hand or something, right?
Mm-hmm. Factory.
Yeah.
Yeah, you'd be with a pickaxe, probably, or something rude and like that.
Something rudimentary, yeah.
Yeah.
Run, Forrest, run!
You missed the ship.
Too late. You missed it.
Is that Bezos?
Is that Bezos?
He's not off the ground.
All right, so pre-order now comes out August 11th, which is when this video releases... 4 days?
August
7th.
This
releases the 7th.
This releases on the 7th, yeah. So it'll be out in 5 days from today if you're watching this on August 7th when this released. Yeah, if you're watching it now, pre-order. August 11th, you'll be playing.
Links are in the basement. Check them out.
We have too many games that are coming out. We got this. We got New World coming out on the 31st. Man, this is too much, guys. We got to start streaming more. Got more group days we got to do. But good gracious, dude, that's just...
Well, if you want us to do that, don't forget to hit that subscribe button. That way, you know, we can actually, you know, leave the other channels alone and just worry about the Syndicate all the time.
Right?
Yeah.
All right, do we want to watch this one time all the way through for everybody?
Sweet. All the time. Yep, no cuts.
No cuts. Okay. We can talk. Yep. That's fine. Just not pausing. Here we go. Look at the ship! Man, everything just looks so good in this game, dude.
It really does.
I'm saying this, I'm not on outside window cleaning duty.
I'm not afraid of heights.
I'll be dead anyway, so it doesn't matter.
Oh, man, I just noticed that as they built that that house, the bottom framework, it made some of the waterfall disappear that was splashing over the rock.
Oh, that's cool. I didn't even notice
that. So it was like kind of situational. Nice.
Yeah.
Yep.
It's a shame that house built down, burned down.
Yeah, I was thinking the same thing. If I built that, I'd be crying. Fire brigade.
They had water to stop the fire.
I know.
Oh. Scary, dude.
Yeah. Nothing like 2,500 pounds running down on you.
It might as well be a million. That looked like a sandstorm too, by the way. I don't think
it did. Yeah. I wonder if it's going to do suit damage and such. That'd be pretty cool. The weather patterns have, you know, effects on our suits.
Oh, that's a good question. Yeah.
You kind of wonder if the way they're running in the storm, trying to get out of it.
I mean, it would make sense because in the winter they did have other, they had supplemental
gear. Like a parka or something on, yeah.
And they did say you didn't want to be out in the storms.
Mm-hmm. Right. Right. Yeah. So, I mean, it would make sense.
Yeah. And they do have a Discord as well, too. So, might be more insider information in there, too.
Yeah. I'm sure there's going to be, one more video probably before their actual release date, which will probably already be out by the time this video comes out. I'm pretty sure. I don't know. I would just assume there would be. It's getting closer to release time. I'm sure they want to drop some more hype. There's plenty of videos for Icarus to go watch, though, guys. If you use this, check the description for the link to the channel, to the Icarus channel, because it's not on RocketWorks. It's on Icarus itself. You can find all their videos and stuff there. It looks so good. I've never... So stuff like Warframe and Destiny, that kind of stuff, where you kind of drop in, drop out, right? Do missions or whatever. I've never really been into that, but I think this might actually change my mind. Because it looks like the sessions are going to be long enough where you can actually build things. So
that's what it's going to depend on me, too, is our session time. You know, if you're only getting 45 minutes at a crack, how the heck are we supposed to build up a building in 45 minutes? You know, so I'm guessing that it's going to be... fair enough time length.
And maybe you can buy upgrades or find upgrades to keep your suit to where you can stay longer.
Yeah, that's possible.
Suit upgrades.
Yeah. I didn't even think about that. That is a good call for sure. You can pick this up on Steam. Right now, it's actually, at the time of this recording, which it may not be a week before the game release, but it's actually 10% off right now. You can pick it up for $26.99 USD for the pre-purchase of just Icarus. Pre-purchase Icarus Deluxe Edition for $89.99. Regular price is $29.99 USD and $99 USD respectively. Offer ends August 20th. So there you go. Yeah, offer ends August 20th. So it'll actually be...
The Deluxe has in it, though.
I don't know. Let's see if we can find some detail for it here real quick. I'm leaving the pre-order now, Icarus August 11th up. We're going to stay in the five-way here for this.
Okay. It's got two DLC chapters.
Yep.
And two outpost levels.
Oh yeah, there it is.
Yeah, DLCs just haven't been released yet.
Yep.
And an exclusive enviro suit. So apparently you can get better gear.
Nice. Maybe. Okay. All right. So I'm going to be grabbing the deluxe edition. I'm just going to go all in on this.
Yeah. It's a gray suit. Dang it. What am I to do?
just buy it for all of us. You'll be fine.
Yep. But wow, that looks good. I am looking at that gray suit on Steam. Looks good. Mm-hmm. Gray being my favorite color.
You get Icarus First Cohort, Icarus New Frontiers DLC when released, Icarus Dangerous Horizons DLC when released, First Cohort exclusive in-game enviro suit with built-in water slot. That seems...
That's important.
Important, yeah. One times Arctic Biome Outpost, persistent map. Yeah. One times Forest Biome Outpost, persistent map. Timed XP bonus on launch. So you get an XP bonus from launch day for a certain amount of time, which seems like a pretty good thing in this game because it seems like it's going to be pretty challenging as it is. So,
mm-hmm. Yep. I'm going to be wearing my red shirts, I think, when I'm playing. I'm going to die a lot.
I feel like we're probably all going to be in that position. Hey, what survival game do we play that one of us doesn't die a lot?
We all die of us seem to have our own specific game that we seem to die more on.
Yeah.
To me, it's every game, so it doesn't matter.
Right. Yeah. All right, last little part here. I sectioned these off as we went through just so I could read a little bit about it between when we were watching the videos and such. Icarus was once destined to be a second Earth. Of course, they said all this in the live-action trailer. Icarus was once destined to be the second Earth, but when terraforming collapsed, the air turned toxic, and humanity's hopes for colonizing a new world died. Icarus became a joke, a symbol of humanity reaching the stars and failing. Yet, when xenobiologists discovered the cause of the failure, exotic matter, a new interest was ignited. Valuable beyond reckoning, these exotics sparked a gold rush, fueling political tensions on Earth and bringing prospectors flocking to Icarus. That's the reason we're going, is because it was supposed to be a second Earth, but then they found rare materials that are worth
lots of money.
Yeah, lots of you.
So this is the new California?
Lots of world dollars. Yeah, that's, I mean, it actually basically says new gold rush. Yeah.
Yeah, mm-hmm. New California.
Sparked a gold rush, yeah. So very cool.
It could be Alaska, too.
It could be, yeah.
Yep.
Canada?
Nah, no one wants to live in Canada.
Yeah, exactly. It's too cold up here for 8 months of the year, man. babies good. That's about it.
But yeah, I mean, there's GameSpot, PC Gamer, Screen Rant. They've all done reviews on the game. July 22nd, they put out the weather systems update. So, or not update, but post recent events and announcements. You can find all that stuff on Steam. And again, we're about 4 or 5 days from launch right now when this video comes out. So go check all that out. You can find all the descriptions down below. You guys got anything else to add?
I just can't wait for the game.
It's on my wish list. I don't know why it's not on yours.
Yeah, for sure.
I say buy it early. Take advantage of the 10% discount.
And the screen right now, I know it says pre-order now, Icarus, August 11th, but Steam actually says August 12th. So I don't know if...
it's probably the time thing. New Zealand time, August 11th. Yeah. North American, August 12th.
That's very possible because North American time is... We're 13 to 16 hours behind New Zealand. So, yeah, or more, depending on where you're at in both of those territories. But, yeah. So, yeah, it could be it. But, yeah, Steam says August 12th for me.
Which would make sense because that's a Thursday and most games get released on Thursdays.
Right. Yep. Yeah, so that's...
Ready for Friday.
Just somewhere around August 11th, August 12th. Be looking for it, of course, in your respective areas. You'll have to check Steam and see what the how many hours till releases or whatever for you. So, but yeah, I mean, if you guys don't have anything else to add, I think that was fantastic. I am super, super excited about this.
Yeah, let us know in the comments what you guys think for sure. I want to know if you guys want A, for us to play, B, what you think of the game, what you think of the graphics. Don't feel afraid to state your opinion on this one. This is beautiful. The game deserves some credit. The game deserves to be talked about for sure.
Definitely does. Well, if that's all for today, then we are going to leave you with the spiel of make sure you subscribe, hit the notification bell, hit the like button, go check out our other projects. We have premieres coming out on Monday and Wednesday at 3 p.m. Eastern. We live stream on Friday night all together here at 8 p.m. Eastern time. And on Saturdays, of course, our podcast pop out pre-recorded videos. So at 9 a.m. Eastern, is that right?
Yep.
Yeah.
Yep.
I think I got all the time. I got everything right this time, guys. It's been a while. Woo-hoo!
Glad you did it because I'd get it wrong.
But with that, Icarus, first cohort, August 11th / 12th, somewhere there. So be sure to check Steam. You can find all the links for everything that we watched today and the Steam page in the description below. So be sure to go check all that out. Show Rocket Two Guns some love for a project that he's been working on and Rocket Works, the company. You guys are doing a fantastic job. With Icarus, thank you so very much for posting everything you have, doing all the interviews you've done. There's lots of videos out there for you guys to go watch. I'm gonna go watch more of them now that we've done this. So
I can't wait to die.
Yeah, it's gonna be great, man. I want to see how you get revived, or do you just start over? Is that it?
Yeah,
mm-hmm. You have to wait for another drop, maybe. Who knows?
Yeah, who knows? All right. Well, if you don't have anything else to add, then I guess we will go see you guys next time. Ayo, Mike.
Thanks for watching. Later, y'all.
on 13.
Please leave a message after the beep. Beep.
Cargo, you're supposed to leave a message.
I'm sorry, I'm too busy laughing. Thanks for watching, everybody. Thanks for being such great people in the community, and I look forward to hearing what you guys have to say.
I think that pretty much sums it up. We'll see you guys next time.